is just straight jitter boogie, and the other is jitter boogie in the family version. Family version is kind of wacky and it sounds a little bit Barnum and Bailey influenced circus music.
Thank you.
bunch of other guitar players in a series of concerts called Guitar Summit, of which I was summited. Thank you.
Seeds take
so flat. I could watch my dog run away for 3 days. There's nowhere in town you could go just after sunset to see the sunset some more. The advantage to it was that when a tornado would come into town, it was no problem because you had so much lead time. This next tune was written while watching one come into town. It's called Silent Anticipation. Thank you. childhood were assimilated by the Borg. This is my guitar, which has been very drastically assimilated. is another brand new tune. Thank you. solid copper. Normally, we try to name or title each tune according to the primary type of music that I'm playing. We haven't had a jazz tour or a rock tour or a classical tour. It's more abstract than that. It usually goes like deep tissue gladiator guitar. Or this particular tour, I think we're going to keep the same as we did earlier in the fall, because it's still strong in the set. And this is a good example of spike collar guitar worker. Upper primate spike collar guitar worker. My girlfriend's a vet.
Thank you.
say, beware dog, you're bound to fall. You thought they were all just kidding you.
Oh,
So rested he by the tum-tum tree. Rats upgrade. Penny is modeling my copper. She's from the Enid, Oklahoma Beauty College. And I'd like to, at this time, for this last number, thank all the members of my crew who are here. Karen, who drives the van and sells the merchandise, and Jill, who takes care of the guitars on stage and changes strings when they break. One just broke. There's an in tune. And Tom, who works the sound for the house for y'all and does all the arranging. Where the wind comes sweeping down the plain, and the waving wheat can sure smell sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain. Oklahoma, every night, my honey lamb and I sit alone and talk. Watch a hawk making lazy circles in the sky. We know we belong to the land, and the land we belong to is grand. So when we say, Yao Kai Bai Hawaii, you know we're saying, you're doing fine, Oklahoma. Oklahoma, okay. L-A, H-O-M-A, Oklahoma, okay. Yeah. First in my series of popular song lyrics, which don't necessarily work as poetry. Second in the series is a spoken word version of a recitation of the song Free Bird. this guitar summit tour, and I had, there were three other guitar players on the bill. I played for 20 minutes and did five tunes. Piece of cake. I forgot what this was like. I like this. And I'd like to thank you all for coming, because this is a 12-day, 11-city tour. This is show number one.
Thank you. Thrash world of Michael Hedges. Since 1984, Michael Hedges has been heralded as the cutting-edge genius of acoustic guitar. He's picked up a following of musicians and a Grammy nomination with an unorthodox style he developed at Baltimore's Peabody Conservatory of Music. Hedges, then a student of composition, electronic music, and classical guitar, wanted to be able to perform his work solo. But he found that the music he was writing wouldn't translate to conventional playing styles.
In order to get the melody separate from the chords and the rhythm, I had to deviate. I would, by day, learn very formulated, codified system of playing classical guitar, but at night I would, Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde.
Hedges was politely asked to leave the Peabody Conservatory, so he moved to California, where he studied computer music and got a record deal with Windham Hill. While acoustic guitar might seem to have little in common with computer music, Hedges feels that the thinking behind both is the same.
If you program a computer to do one thing, it's really your mind going through into the computer. Why not just make your mind go into your hand and use your computer experience to enhance your guitar?
Hedges also plays some unorthodox electric guitars as well as flute and keyboards, but acoustic guitar remains his strong suit for composition and pure flash. For fans who've heard his records and come to see the show, his guitar playing is the show.
It's always been a surprise to people who have heard my records to see that things are coming from one instrument. Maybe they think it's a part of like a band or two guitars or something. So my visuals have always sort of made people wonder.
The latest of Michael Hedges' many albums is called Taproot.
I'm a hunter-gatherer. I'm primal guitar.
Okay.
I'll find and use anything I can hunt down, which is what the Spanish gypsies did, you know, with flamenco. I like flamenco music quite a bit because it's always changing. My tunings are original. There's nothing in my list of compositions for a guitar that is in a standard tuning. The music usually dictates what my tuning will be. And the music's different every time. What I hear comes into the guitar in a non-standard tuning. It breaks down any knowledge that you expect of relationships between the strings. So it's like you learn 10 chords, but then on the next tune, you got everything changed around, so you got to make them up. And that's what's expansive about it, is that you're not glued into any kind of particular chord from song to song. If you change the tuning, your whole universe is wiped away. That I made up that had to do with mythology is called Taproot. And Taproot was a story that I was trying to tell with music. It's not songs. There's one song on it, but I'm not trying to tell the story with words. It's kind of like when the soundtrack is the movie. That's what my idea was, to make a movie with sound, or a story with the sound, a concept instrumental album.
Sometimes it works to plug poetry into a song. So this is what I did with a poem by E.E. Cummings called I Carry Your Heart.
Other records aren't necessarily mythic, or there isn't a symbolic, direct symbolic relationship to my own life. In Taproot, however, it is. It's very personal. It's a personal myth told in sound. Happen when one realizes something that opens up an area of consciousness. And then when you get that extra part of your brain or whatever opens up, I don't know, you know, physiologically what's happening, but it has to do with an opening of some new consciousness. That's the only way I can put it. Because then you have room. Then you have room to experiment. You have room to grow.
It's time to talk. It's time I speak. The switch is on, the light is green. Send me down this road. I will find my sister's soul. I really want to know my sister's soul deep inside me. A free sister's soul is here in hiding.
If I think about maybe experimenting with sounds that come in and arouse me or expand me or help me become wiser, then when I'm playing, that's the tone of the piece.
Time to talk, it's time I seek. My breath is drawn, I'm awake. And I'll rock, I will roll, I will find my sister's soul. Thank you. sister soul.